story of the tortoise and the hare. The tortoise and the hare were odd fellows to be such friends, but they were, and it was a rare day indeed when they could not be seen together. The hare was so jumpy and so speedy and so full of life that he rarely stood still even for a moment. The tortoise was totally the opposite. He slept a lot, and when he did decide to move anywhere, he did so very slowly and very carefully. Of course, we must remember that the tortoise had to take his house with him when he wanted to move. "I don't see why you have to take your house with you everywhere you go," said the hare.
"I don't see why you have to make a new home every time you move away," said the tortoise.
"Why don't you just make one good home and stick to it?" But as I said, they were good friends, and they just accepted that they were different. One of their friends, Mole, was very mischievous. He had a habit of popping out of the ground just when other animals were thinking they were all alone. He spent most of his life tunnelling underground, and one day, deep under the ground, he found a golden ring. "I think I would like to see a race," Mole announced. "I do love to see a good race. So I am prepared to offer this valuable gold ring as a prize. It shall be presented to the winner." "But who's going to race?" asked the wise old owl. "Is anybody allowed to enter?" "Oh, dear me, no," said Mole with a smile. "That would be most unfair, for some of us are far faster than others. Some of us are far stronger than others, and so on."
"Then what do you propose?" asked Owl.
"I've been thinking about it a lot," replied Mole, "and I've come to the conclusion that what we all would most like to see is a fine race between two competitors. I suggest Tortoise here and his friend the Hare." Well, this caused a howl of laughter.
"The Tortoise and the Hare?" laughed Owl. "I thought you said the competitors should be a fair match for each other. Why, who on this earth would ever think the tortoise could win?"
"As a matter of fact," Mole said quietly, "I think he could, under certain conditions. And this is my race. I will set the conditions, after a discussion with both of them." Very soon, every animal for miles around had heard the news. There was to be a race between the hare and the tortoise. Mole was offering a gold ring for the prize, and it was being said that Mole actually thought the tortoise had a fair chance. Well, it seemed impossible to believe. Some of the animals thought Mole must have gone off his head. Meanwhile, Mole was talking to the hare and the tortoise.
"As I see it," he said, "to make the race fair, we will let the tortoise decide what sort of a race it should be, how far, and over what sort of ground, and so on. Do you think you could agree with that, Hare?" Hare was sure he must win. He was prepared to agree with almost anything.
"Oh, that's fine by me," he said rather grandly. "I don't want to boast, but when it comes to running, I have yet to meet my better, and I somehow doubt that my friend Tortoise here could beat me over any ground, or over any distance."
"What do you say, Tortoise?" asked Mole.
"May I have time to think about this?" asked the tortoise.
"Of course you may," replied Mole. "Shall we meet a week from now in this very spot? That gives me time to make sure that every animal hears the news. I would dearly like to see a big crowd, as most of all I want to see everyone enjoying themselves." Mole watched as the hare and the tortoise went off. When he was alone again, he giggled to himself. But he wasn't alone, as he thought. The wise old owl was perched on a branch just above his head.
"Just what are you up to?" he suddenly said, making Mole jump.
"Why, nothing," said Mole. "I am merely interested in racing, and I want everyone to have a jolly good time."
"Most of all, you," said Owl. "You're up to something, I know."
"Not really," said Mole.
"But you are a wise fellow, and you might understand what I have in mind. You see, I've given a chance for Tortoise to turn the tables, if he has the brain for it, and I think he has.
Well, as for hair, well, between you and me, I think he's a bit crazy, don't you?
They don't call him the Mad March Hare for nothing, said Owl.
Exactly, said Mole. And although it is not yet the month of March, it soon will be. I hope Tortoise remembers that.
Tortoise did remember that.
He went away and he thought a lot about the race. So, exactly 1 week later, they all met again in the very same spot. Mole asked them both if they were ready to race.
Ready, asked Hare. I was ready a week ago. I'm ready now, and I would be ready a week from today. I don't want to hurt my poor friend's feelings here, but as far as I'm concerned, this race is won before we start.
And how about you, Tortoise, asked Mole. Are you ready?
Yes, replied Tortoise. I think I've found the perfect course for us to race over. It is in the town nearby. There's a proper track, nice and smooth, and I think we should race round and round the track. But, to make it fair, after all, my friend here is quite a nippy fellow. I think the race should be over a long distance, which suits me better. I suggest, for example, the first one of us to go round the track exactly 100 times is the winner.
100 times, said Mole.
Yes, said Tortoise. That's if my friend agrees.
I agree, said Hare. The first one of us to go round the track 100 times gets the gold ring, right?
Right, said Mole. And the race was set. They went across several fields until they came to the town. There was the track. Hare was surprised to see a great crowd had turned up to see the race. Most of them seemed to be away on the far side of the course, near some large stands.
Should we start the race here? Said the tortoise.
Anywhere you like suits me, replied Hare.
So Mole gave them a ready, steady go. And off they went. Within a few minutes, Hare was round the other side of the track. Tortoise had only gone a few yards, and he seemed to be in no hurry.
Hare was enjoying himself. As he passed the stands, he looked at all the people who'd come to watch. He wondered why they were all laughing. Then behind him, he heard a bell start ringing. And soon after that, he heard a buzzing noise coming from behind. He looked round and saw something he'd never seen before. It was very odd indeed, but it looked as though someone had made an imitation hare which was coming along to join him. He leapt along for another few yards, wondering who would do such a silly thing. Then, to his horror, he heard a noise he had heard before. It sounded exactly like a pack of dogs after him. And when he looked, it was a pack of dogs. There were six of them, wearing silly coloured jackets, and they were coming towards him very quickly indeed.
Yikes! Cried Hare, and he was off. When he came to the point where the track bent round to the left, Hare didn't bother. He was off, running for his very life. He leapt the fence and disappeared into the country. It took the tortoise a long, long time to go round the track 100 times, but he was in no hurry. Somehow he knew that the hare would not be too interested in coming back for a while. So the tortoise won the great race and got the gold ring, and the hare learned a good lesson. As long as there are two in a race or more, you can never be absolutely certain who's going to win.
The Story of the Ugly Duckling.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.